Hello, everyone. Dick Enberg along with Randy Cross in Jacksonville, Florida for your NFL recaps presented to you by Lexus. Well, quite a game again. Week after week, it comes down to the final play for us. We've been well blessed by exciting action. How about this one?
We have. Well, so much for the soft part of Jacksonville's schedule. Cleveland comes in here 2-4 and acts like the team that beat the Giants 2 weeks ago on a Monday night. I mean, they really looked sharp. I thought it was the best execution, including that Giants game, that I'd seen out of this team against a Jacksonville team who was ready to play, ready to put up a good performance. They just got out big played by the Cleveland Browns.
Of our three stars, Matt Jones is one of them, and he nearly was the biggest star on that desperation pass in the final minute where he had his hands on it three different times juggling in the end zone. Would have been his ninth catch and a touchdown to win the game.
And it tells you really what this Jacksonville team will miss when we find out Monday or Tuesday how much his suspension will be for when that appeal is heard by the NFL.
We've heard that it's probably three games and they're appealing for it to be two. And how about Jamal Lewis? We mentioned at the start of the telecast, when he rushes 20 times in a game, the Browns are 10-1. Well, they're now 11-1, and he had 20 rushes right on the nose in this one.
And that goes to Joe Thomas and that offensive line. They did a very nice job against a big physical front for the Jacksonville Jaguars. And Derek Anderson, you know, you and I both said it. Jack Del Rio was studying tape of Brady Quinn coming into this game, figuring that Derek Anderson would blink against his defense, and man, he did not blink a lick.
He was really solid. Here's Kellen Winslow, and with all the distraction of that suspension and then retraction and yet still a fine, and I think anybody around football would say, hey, how can the Browns come in here? They're underdogs playing against a tough Jacksonville team with the incident. And be able to concentrate on the game.
Well, not even Romeo. Romeo Crennel had no idea how his team was going to react. He says, what I've found is when you have these kind of distractions, you don't know until they kick that thing off how your team is really going to react to that kind of a negative influence. And there was nothing negative about what that situation was as far as how it affected their performance on the field tonight.
It adds to a delicious 23-17 victory for the Cleveland Browns on the road. And that's it for now. Tune in next weekend. More NFL action on CBS Sports. Our coverage begins at noon Eastern with the NFL Today. And throughout the week, stay on top of all the latest NFL news and coverage from around the league at CBSSports.com.